Protecting our coast, marsh, and wildlife from the oil is a huge priority for everyone, including BP. It's a job that will continue until the leak is stopped and likely for years to come. WDSU anchor LaTonya Norton spoke with BP CEO Tony Hayward to get answers to the questions we are all asking.
It's the latest effort to stop the oil leaking into the Gulf of Mexico. It was the latest setback for the company trying to stop the crude from further damaging waters, wildlife, and the marshland. I am joined by BP's chief executive officer, Mr. Tony Hayward in Venice. Mr. Hayward, thank you so much for joining us. Now, we tried the coffer dam. We've tried the top hat, the top kill. All of these efforts have failed. What's next in the cleanup?
Thank you, Rihanna, for the opportunity. We're all disappointed that the top kill failed, probably no one more than myself. Having concluded yesterday afternoon that it wasn't going to work, we immediately moved ahead with the plan to install a containment cap above the well, on top of the lower marine riser package, as it's called, with the intention to produce the oil and gas to surface. That operation is ongoing, and we expect to have it operating by the end of the week.
All right, so we will know by the end of the week whether or not this latest effort will be successful. Has BP done absolutely everything in its power to solve this problem?
We have been working with the industry, with government scientists, with all of the great minds in this country to engineer solutions to this problem. We've created a multiple-step plan such that if one piece of the plan does not work, we can immediately go to the next one, and that is what you're seeing. So whilst, as I say, we're all very disappointed that the top kill didn't work, we have the next piece of the plan already in train, ready to go. What we've learnt through this is, of course, a lot about what it will take to contain the well. And the new solution is specially engineered to create a tight fit at the top of the well and absolutely contain the oil and gas that's coming out.
And you are joining us from Venice. We know it's been 41 days into this spill. What do you have to say to the fishermen, to the families? What do you have to say to the very people whose lives depend on the marshlands?
Well, the first thing I clearly want to say is I'm sorry. I'm very sorry that this has impacted people down here to the extent it has. Since the very beginning, we have thrown enormous resources at this to contain the leak on the seabed, to contain the oil on the surface, and to defend the shoreline. And we continue to do that. We have the largest environmental response in the country's history is ongoing, and it will stay until we've dealt with it. Over the last 4 or 5 days, we have significantly increased the shoreline defence. We've created a series of forward positions, flotels out on the edge of the shore where the cleanup teams are now living such that they can get instantly to the areas where oil is coming ashore. We've got camps established along the beaches such that the teams can be working this problem 15 to 18 hours a day. There is no transport time. One of the challenges we've had is because the foreshore of Louisiana is so remote, our challenge has been getting people on location quickly. We've significantly upped the ante in that regard in the last 4 or 5 days. And I hope that's going to make a big impact. I'm devastated every time we have a cup of oil on the shore, and we are going to throw all the resources of BP, the Coast Guards, the National Guard, all of the people who are working this. We are going to defend to the maximum extent possible the shoreline.
All right, a lot of people devastated by this incident. Once again, Tony Hayward, CEO of BP, thank you so much for joining us. Hopefully one of these options will work sooner rather than later. Scott, back to you.